Let's talk about spatial positioning, right? Panning in JackTrip. Let's assume for a second that you are getting together with a trio, you all sing together, and you want to make sure that you're all not just coming from the center, but maybe are spread around in a virtual JackTrip space for it to sound better. How can you do that, right? So in the audio settings, I would assume in that case, you all are sending one mono channel. So what you could do is you go to the studio settings. You, by the way, first of all, might want to select, let's say, small choir here, right? A preset, which changes your audio setting to be a bit more spacious. You will have some reverb, some slight compression and things that are dedicated for a little ensemble or choir in this case. So I'm going to go to studio settings here. And well, first of all, you might want to select a preset here, a studio soundscapes, or you might already have selected one. In this case, maybe small choir would be a good idea. I'm going to say proceed anyway. I don't need to save my current configuration. So you now have selected your preset, right? Or you have your favorite one in there. But how do you specifically think about panning? Let's go to the Manage Soundscape button here, which is the web app of JackTrip, where we can look a bit more in depth on all of our settings. So I am going to go to the Soundscapes tab here, which is already selected. And you can see our preset here is selected. And basically, selecting this preset input all of these different links, right? So we have a little noise gate. We have some compression on the output master chain. We are cutting off everything below 75 hertz. So all these little perks that came with selecting that preset. But the main thing I want to look at in this video with you is the panning module here. You can see that you actually have different panning modules. One of them is the normal pan, which does not appear on this list right now because it's already input here. But we also have the circular pan and spherical pan available. I want to briefly talk to you about why all of these say mono to stereo. We assume in this case that that every participant is just sending one channel to JackTrip, right? We're all singers, so we all have one microphone. We don't have a beautiful stereo piano that we send to JackTrip, which we want to be repositioned somewhere as a mono sound source again. We don't, in that case, we wouldn't want a panning module, right? Because it already sounds stereo, it already sounds great. But in this case, since we're three people that all just sing together, we might want some reverb, maybe some compression, some noise gating, and we want to please be positioned in space to make the best out of our headphones and all this technology involved. So when you select one of them, and I'm going to say pan, the normal pan module here, you can see in the description, positions each musician in a simple stereo field. Note that all incoming clients with stereo signals will be summed to mono. This is what I was saying. If you send stereo, this might not be the best effect for you because this applies to every musician, right? So everyone will get positioned in space at different positions, but the stereo information will be summed to mono and then positioned. So this is not something that's working for every case. In this case, it's wonderful because we can say, look, we have three musicians and please make sure that all of these musicians are panned in a certain range around me, right? Maybe in this case, we don't want them to be hard panned all the way to the left and the right, but maybe almost, you know? So now JackTrip automatically for each musician positions every different musician in that space. And it sounds great. I want to lastly talk about one other pan alternative here. We have circular pan and spherical pan, right? Let's do circular pan, which is my personal favorite. And you can read in the info box here that this is actually not just simple stereo. This is spatial audio, meaning we are making use of our actual hearing, how we perceive sound naturally. We're not just saying, okay, make it louder here or make it louder there. We're using time delay between the ears. We're using HRTFs, which is what our outer ears, you know, the way we naturally hear, you know, why we can perceive all these differences that's happening by certain peaks and notches in the frequency spectrum based on our outer ear. Long story short, I think it sounds better on headphones. So make sure to play around with circular pan. Same thing. In this case, I think we said we are three musicians. So now we don't have left and right. We actually have back left and back right, right? This is a circular panning. So I don't love it too far. I'm just gonna say, let's maybe go like 90 degrees and try it out. And I think you will hear the difference to normal pan. So have fun playing around with these panning modules. And again, if most of your musicians are already sending stereo signal, maybe because you've mixed them on a mixer, or you know, you have two microphones recording your drum set or instruments, this might not be for you. This is applying to all musicians, making all channels into one sound source, and then positioning that in your, in this case, three-dimensional space. Have fun using panning in JackTrip.